Ashok Vyasan, Young India Cultural Group is a wonderful organization. It is connecting with youth and sharing the practical application of ancient wisdom. So here I have the pleasure of standing with Rati Rajaji, and today is a very special day, some sort of a celebration of the Gita teaching, which is continuing for many years. So Rati, what is happening today here?
Today is my annual program called Gita Vichara. And we study all year on applying the wisdom teachings, ancient teachings, to contemporary problems. And we explore verses, we explore values, concepts, life principles. And today is the annual forum where they present their work over the last year. And this year in particular, we're developing something called Make Your Life series. And what does that mean? That means that we are presented with obstacles and opportunities. And can we apply the teachings of the Gita, the values, the verses, the life principles, the meditations, the concepts of Bhagwan in different manifestations? Can we apply some of it to overcoming either the obstacle or striving for the opportunities that present to oneself?
So Rhea is a 17-year-old girl who's about to go to college. She's always had a passion for photography, and she would like to pursue that as a major in college. However, her parents are very strict about her being a doctor. So Rhea has to make a decision about what she wants to do in college and what she wants to major. And she needs to discover and she needs to realize what she wants. And we're going to explain how she can cope with the situation.
So now, what is your name?
Anushka.
Anushka, so we go one by one, and if I start with you, do you smile quite often or less?
A little bit less.
Okay. What's your name?
Yash.
Okay, Yash, when she mentioned about Rhea's dilemma, then you guys were thinking about the solution. Who came up with the solution first?
Well, I mean, we all had different aspects of the solution, right? So so we thought of like different ways she could deal with the problem. So, okay, so, like, each one of us just thought about different perspectives, different parts of it. So, like, I thought about, like, how she could interact with her parents. They thought about how she could, like, break it to her parents what she could do beforehand, and just, like, things like that.
Okay, so that's Yash. That's Anushka, Arya, Thea, and I'm Sanjana. So, one of the other things that Rhea can use is values. Values such as Yesha, which is fame, and her parents want her to achieve the recognition and fame through becoming a doctor, but she wants to achieve the recognition and fame by becoming a photographer. If someone is really passionate about something, they have the incentive and they have the drive to go towards and be successful in what they really want to. Suppose she becomes a doctor. She doesn't have that same passion. She doesn't have that same drive. So she might actually achieve a lower level of success and recognition than she might by becoming a photographer.
So being a part of this whole exercise, what did it teach you individually? Is there something where you felt that, oh, Bhagavad Gita is addressing that particular problem of mine?
So yeah, this taught me to work in a group, and I also learned that to be open-minded, to listen to your parents, because for this situation, Rhea's parents have a lot more experience than she does. They're so much older than her, and they work, and they're just trying to do the best for her. So they're asking her to be a doctor so that she can be able to, she can support her family, and she can have a sufficient life instead of maybe being a photographer.
Bhagwan says, chapter 10, verse 35, on I am spring among the seasons. So, I thought I'd comment on why Bhagwan says he's spring among the seasons. Spring represents a new beginning, a time for renewal, maybe recuperation, or re-energizing. Maybe it's time to clear the heart and mind of anger and regrets. It is a marking point, and nature provides us with the total spirit around us. There's greenery around us, new plants are coming, and just, you know, the air is different. And it's a period for growth and blossoms. So in this digital era of really no seasons, because everything is temperature controlled for us, our car, our homes, wherever we go, our connection with nature is kind of depleted. And then with the electricity, we have day. We don't really transition from day to night with the sun. We sleep whenever we sleep. Spring is a time to reflect on transitions.
And lastly, in the month of June, 25 years is a small time if you are talking about centuries, but it's really a long time if you are talking about a human life. So Silver Jubilee of Young India Cultural Group is being celebrated in the month of June. Talk to me a little bit about that event.
We are really acknowledging the work of so many people, over 100 people really, who have strived for this organization, 25 years of giving back in so many aspects of our culture. And that's only the tip of the iceberg. We've been a community for our friends and family. We've seen our kids. We've seen our grandkids coming in. So we want to mark this point. We want to mark this point and celebrate our 25 years. It is a family event.
And when, where?
It's going to, well, the gala that we're having is at Leonard's in Great Neck on June 9th.